Good evening and welcome to tonight's regularly scheduled meeting of the Board of Education. Would people please silence their phones and please stand and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you, everyone. And we'll start the proceedings with the calling of the roll, please.
That would be me. All right.
Yeah, thank you for subbing.
Yes. President Wasserman.
Here.
Vice President Branstad, I am here. Secretary Baker is absent. Treasurer Singer.
Here.
Member Frazee.
Here.
Member Gorton.
Here.
And Member McFarland.
Here.
All right, 6 out of 7.
And for everybody, Secretary Baker is out on a church youth group trip in Maryland. Helping some underprivileged folks, so she's dealing with youth even as she's gone.
Yeah, there's 70 Midland Public School kids with her.
With her, yep. More than we have tonight.
There you
go. First item on the agenda is the consent agenda. You can see the listing of items, of last meeting's minutes, staff measure and a member resignations, the school district improvement plans that were posted prior, some books for approval that were posted prior, seat time waiver application, read the details of that, asbestos abatement at both Northeast and Jefferson, district custodial supplies for the year, warehouse painting, approval of school systems bills for the month of May, and legal invoices as listed in the agenda. Any additions or deletions requested, and any comment or questions?
I guess I have a comment. When I looked at the district custodial supplies, I was impressed by the 12 different estimates for all these different supplies, trying to making sure we can get the best possible price. And I was just really impressed. You know, sometimes you hear people say you need to run this like a business. And I'd like to say, I see we're running it as well or better in some cases. We're just really doing due diligence and getting the best price we possibly can. So I appreciate that.
And that we have local vendors giving us the best price, which is nice. Out of Bay City, two contracts out of Midland, one out of Gladwin.
Yep.
Good to see.
Good comments. Any others? Seeing none, I'll accept the motion to approve the consent agenda.
I move we approve consent agenda items 2.1 through 2.10.
Moved by Angela. Support?
Support.
Support by Pam. All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? The ayes have it. Move on to Board of Education matters, and I'm going to hand it over to, I guess, Bob for the first item.
Correct.
Yep. We'll just get the screen here for a minute. Not very many slides, but a couple. Just to make sure everyone remembers the process we're going through, it can get confusing because all the budgets are running concurrently. We're trying to end one and start another, and we really haven't even reached the end point yet. So we're about a week earlier than we normally are. But what I'm going to kick it off with is the final budget adjustment for 14-15, and then Mike will take that from there and go back over the 15-16 budget, which we discussed at our last meeting back on the 8th of June. Our timeline we've been following all along takes us to the final thing there, which is the board action. And so I'll be asking you for approval of the 14-15 budget and the final revised copy, I should say. And then, like I said, Mr. Chair would be following up with the adoption of the 15-16 original budget. I really just wanted to summarize it with actually a single slide, which I got a copy for everybody. And I wanted to do that because it kind of gives you the picture of everything we're going to talk about here in the next couple of minutes. But basically, if you remember back in March, which was the last time we adjusted the budget, so that very first column all the way to the left-hand side was our estimate. We were at that time, if you remember, you can see where our revenues and expenditures were. We thought we'd have some variance, about $617,000. We actually had more than that. But you can see we were anticipating at this time of year we'd have a shortfall somewhere around $2.2 million. In actuality, when we present to you tonight the final 2014 June budget. We still do have a week to go, but I think we've built in enough contingencies for that. You'll see that Actually, our revenues came in a little bit higher than we thought back in March. Not a whole lot, kind of little minor things along the way that change. And the expenditures actually is where we actually came in much better than we thought we were going to at that time. No one area, it's really just where we were standing in March and what we actually spent by the end was a pretty good variance, sort of like we've been historically. So it didn't hurt us as much as we thought in March when we had pushed a little bit harder for those. But you'll see the anticipated shortfall then as we end this year is going to stand at 1.4, a little bit more than that, about 1.4 million as opposed to the 2.2 we had predicted back in March. I go back further than that, you know, we've talked about this before. We started the year with the original June budget was 4.9. We thought that would be 3.3. And just from the work, as we've talked before, the things we've done, we've done a pretty good job this year. You can see where your fund balance will stand at the end. And you'll see that while in March we thought it'd be 8.1, it's really going to come in at 9.2%. So if there's any questions to answer, I'd be glad to, but we really just the final revised budget for
14-15. Okay, we'll stop with that. Any, first of all, accept the motion for approving the budget for final budget for 14-15.
I will move to approve the budget for the final budget for 14-15.
Moved by Pam.
I'll support that.
Support by Patrick. Open for discussion and questions. I thought Pam was going to ask one.
No, I'm excited about how far we've come. It just shows a great effort by the whole school. Just it hasn't been easy, I know, but it really gives me great pride, and I look forward to what I see at the end of the 15-16 with even reducing that more. So. Hats off. I think we're moving in a great direction.
Any others? I concur. Thanks to leadership, to people executing in the buildings, everybody watching, your earlier comment, Pam, everybody watching every penny, every dime, every day to make sure we can continue educating our kids. And it's been a great year, and even with saving all that money, I mean, it we still get the results. So I'm very, very happy. It keeps us off that edge, and we're going to be a thriving district from here as we move forward. That, if you recall, and I may have the number wrong, Bob, wasn't the original budget for this year without variances at 5-something?
Yep, just shy.
And we expected 3.5-ish with variances.
Yep.
So even with the historic variances and historic discipline, we expected to have a 3.5 shortfall, and we got less than 1.5. shortfall, $2 million over the course of the year. It's an outstanding performance by everybody on the financial side. Excellent. Any other comments? Seeing none, we'll voice vote for approval of the final budget of this school year. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? The ayes have it.
And then to hand it over to Mike, I'm just going to point out that the last column is what was presented back in 15-16, so just kind of lead you to where we're at and what we're projecting going forward. I do want to remind you that the one thing I wanted to make sure is that the 15-16 budget we started developing before we had the 14-15 finished. There's no other way to do that. So I don't, what I just presented to you is not necessarily reflected in the 15-16. Sometime at adjustment time after we get started next year, we'll do an adjustment and some of that shorter, smaller anticipated shortfall will be reflected when you get there. So when you're looking at the 15-16 budget and where the fund balance will be and percent of expenditures, you can expect that to change when it reflects it. So I just wanted to remind you of that before Mike went ahead and 15-16.
And you know, Bob did a great job 2 weeks ago going through the detail of that budget, but so I'm just going to touch a few highlights of it and talk a little bit how we got here. So, you know, like all of you, I am excited about the progress we've made. You know, probably wasn't, you know, month on the job and start thinking, oh, God, you know, what did I get myself into here? But we've made great progress, but at the same time, as much as I want to be optimistic, we're not out of it yet, and we still got some work to do. you know, we're showing an anticipated shortfall of that 15-16 budget of 800,000. But, you know, that's with the part of the variance in there. So it could almost be 1.6. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm going to bet as great of a job everyone in the district has done, we're going to beat that 800,000 is what our goal is. And if you remember, with our recent downsizing of personnel, our concessions that we've asked from our employee group, our plan is to have it balanced over 2 years. We may beat that. Who knows, right? It's yet to be done. But I don't want to get too optimistic because there's lots of things, lots of variables still to come. Like, remember, this budget is built on a student count that we don't know yet. So a predicted student count that we'll know in October after count day. It's also somewhat predicted on predicted revenues, even though the state legislature has officially adopted the budget. There's still sometimes some surprises when we get those state aid payments and they come forward, coming forward. And so the variance generally for our district, though, is student count and what can we save during the year? What can we reduce as we're going along? Someone leaves a district, let's not fill that position for a while. You know, those type of things, which we really, really did well this year. And let me go back to that budget this year. We did most of that, by the way. Reduction of personnel, reducing everyday operating budgets without really anyone even noticing. So we did it through attrition on the personnel side. Coming into 15-16, we're pretty fortunate to have almost done that again. There was a few employees affected, as you know. Some of that had to do with certifications. One and a half or two employees that were affected through there. But we did it through attrition again, real well. And the other part of that, to build the budget, our building budgets, our department budgets out there, they did a great job of giving us money back out of their budget, so they're going to spend less next year going forward as well. So again, I think you're right when you said that this is a team effort. We've asked a lot from everybody in the district, but I think we'll all be better off in the future as well for that as we go forward. So you know, without greater detail of the budget, that is the 15-16 budget. Bob's got the numbers there for you. 7.3% fund balance, even though I'm not a big percentage fund balance guy. I really believe it's more about the number of dollars you have on cash, you have on hand, and how many days could you operate with that cash if you had no revenue coming in. Because percentages can change, because as you can see, we had a $79 million budget the prior year, and now we're $78 million budget. So when you figure the percentage of your surplus, it's now figured on a different number. So I think sometimes that can be deceiving, and make sure it's really about cash flow and how much cash flow are we going to have as we go forward. But we're going to get low. We're predicting 7.3. I think that's our bottom, and that's awful close to the recently moving forward emergency legislation where we'd have to do some self-reporting. I don't remember the exact number. Do you, Bob? Is it 7?
I think it's 7.
I think it's 7, period. So we're awful close. But I do believe that's our bottom point, and then we may begin to move back forward, which we should. We're too low at this point in time for our liking as well.
Yeah, almost by definition, since this year's going to end up at 7.4, just shifting that number over will be a 6.6.
Yeah,
which will increase, you know, with all the same spending and revenue next year, we're starting with a higher fund balance to start with versus these comparisons. Yep. So.
The other one I want to add is we delayed some costs to us with our employee group's concessions. Now, steps, lanes will come back in 2 years, so we have to grow into those. Keep that in mind when I say we're all feeling better, but in 2 years we have an automatic $750,000 cost increase in that ballpark. Coming forward, so we need to grow into those. Mm-hmm. Thank you to our employees for giving us that time period and that concessions to grow back into that those automatic increases. And that's without anyone getting a percentage pay increase. Those are automatics that we have to grow back into. So looking better, trending positive, heading forward. Great job by everyone, but probably just a little bit of close eye watching when you still need to do for a few years. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so any questions or comments to Mike? Okay, and with that, as the column shows, that would be the budget for next, the summary of the budget for next year as stands. And the first revision will include all the updates that's happened now from the end of this year.
To all student count?
Yep. Including, yeah, that'd be the biggie. Okay, if there are no questions or comments, we'll move into a vote. All in favor of approving the 15-16 budget as articulated, say aye.
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 Jerry, we didn't have a...
Oh, yeah, we never made a motion.
Oh, I didn't have a motion.
How about I move that we approve the 2015-16 budget?
And I'll support that.
Okay. Angela and Yvonne. And this is a roll call for budget?
I don't think it's, you have to legally, but it's probably a good idea.
Let's go ahead. Let's call the roll for the vote.
Okay, President Wasserman.
Yes.
Vice President Branstad, yes. Treasurer Singer.
Yes.
Member Frazee.
Yes.
Member Gorton.
Yes.
Member McFarland.
Yes.
All right, 6 out of 6.
6 out of 6. We have a budget for next year. And hopefully we'll do better than it.
Yeah.
Okay, moving on to salary adjustments for employee groups for next year. Mike?
Not touching right where we were. So we have a salary letter there for our 14 groups of employees. As you've had in the past, following the exact same format. This letter was probably slightly different as we were talking before we started the meeting. Where it talks a little bit about the concessions our employee groups have made. We tried to apply the same format, the same model to all employee groups as we went through. You know, some things fit for each employee group. Some have some of the same things they could give up. Health insurance rate increases, I think, was just about for every employee group, for an example. But there were some areas where that didn't work, and so we have to reach into a different category to come up with a dollar amount. We were trying to get about 3.8% from each employee group. That was about the right dollar amount that was coming through there, and we did reach that with all employee groups, and we were able to do that, and the salary letter reflects that as well going forward. 2015-16 salary letter for your approval.
Take a motion to approve.
Motion to approve the salary letter.
Thank you, Pam.
Support.
Support, support by Angela. Any discussion or questions?
Just thank you again to everyone who's put in so much work and sacrifice to get there.
To get where it is.
Right.
Exactly. It's the culmination of all negotiations and everything else. Okay. Any others?
No, I echo what Angela said.
Okay, with that in mind, we can just do a voice vote on that. All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? The ayes have it. Number one, superintendent contract renewal. As per Mike's earlier comment, I'll do a little level setting here. First of all, we evaluate Mike's performance on an annual basis in December because of the timing when he started, and we can shift that eventually, but right now we're on a December-December evaluation. And then his contract renewal would reflect that evaluation. And we do his contract, which is a July 1 to July 1 contract in the month of June. Towards his earlier comment of employee groups taking haircuts in various categories, Mike wanted to lead by example and has done so by proposing to us contract changes that reflect what other groups did and to the same or even higher degree. Mike's total compensation package, total contract cost to the district will decrease 4% next year, 4.0, where the other groups are at 3.8%. They're in similar categories, but some of them mismatch because he doesn't have some the others have and vice versa. The three compensation areas that he'll be impacted is with the health insurance to the same percentage point increase. 1% of their pay increase everybody else had, but recognizing being the district's highest paid employee, he's now incurred the highest cost increase in his insurance also. Pays the most and has incurred the highest cost increase. The other area is his vacation. His vacation will carryover will be reduced by 5 days. While that may not be an immediate cash impact to the district, it's an immediate liability improvement decrease to the district as soon as the contract is signed, and will be a cash impact if they're ever cashed out. And the last area is in I'm having a mad cow moment. Conferences, thank you. The contract called for 2 conferences a year, 1 national, 1 state, and we are eliminating the national contract this year. That all adds up to the 4% cost savings. And those are the same kind of areas other groups were pulled from as could happen. The one thing that's different that's not financial or immediately financial is our rating and performance evaluation of Mike was very high last year. We were very happy. We've only had good things happen since then, stupendously good things since then. Bond passage, a contract that was done well and also helps with the budget. And proposing his contract to extend his contract to the maximum allowable by law to the 5 years. To recall, a history lesson on that is when he was hired in, we began him at 3. And if he said his performance merited, we would increase that 1 year, a year at a time, as his performance, as a show of confidence, raising that to 5 years from the 4 that it was year, from the 3 it was before. So those are the 4 areas. Any questions or comment before I call for a motion?
Yeah, I have a comment. I appreciate the leadership. And to come back and take the same amount or even higher hits to your whole compensation package, just like we've gone to the employees and asked, it really shows great leadership, and I appreciate that.
Thanks.
I second what Pam says. I was just amazed at the way you went after the bond proposal, and you got it, and I thought that was great. That was really...
Well worked by a lot of people. It was good.
It was outstanding, yes. And then, like Pam said, too, I think a good leader is one who will do the same that he asked his employees for. So thank you so much for that.
You lead by example, and you do that with everything you do. You don't expect anybody to do anything that you won't, and you've demonstrated that again. And not only that, you came to us and worked that out on your own merit, your own proposal. It was just fantastic. So we're all really proud to have you, and great job.
Bob did the work on putting the money together.
Any others?
My short time, a lot of the same comments. I've enjoyed it. I think you're wonderful for the district, and I look forward to coming years.
Yep. Thanks.
Thanks, Mike.
Thank you.
Yep. Mike, I would diddle all those comments, and as a board member, one of the things we have to do is worry about retention also, and I hope a one-year extension makes you feel that we're a full vote of confidence by this board on your leadership and your team's leadership going forward.
It does.
And I hope that helps with that and makes you understand that we truly do appreciate what you're doing.
Yep. Thank you very much.
Okay, with that in mind, we'll call for a vote.
Well, how about I move that we approve the superintendent contract renewal.
Thank you. Thank you, Angela and Pam, for catching me flat-footed a second time tonight. We did the comments already, so all in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? Crickets? I would show it as unanimous vote. Thank you, Mike.
Thank you.
We'll move on to the bond proceeds investment advisory services approval.
Starter Birch is our financial consultant, and we're being probably the largest, most reputable firm in the state. And they also help us invest those proceeds. So we were giving a lot of money in this recent bond sale. $72 million, is that right, Bob?
Yep.
$72 million. And part of that bond, when it was built and applied for to the Treasury, is you have to show that you're going to invest in what amount you're going to make and how that works into the formula of the payoff. And so when that was built and our application was put in with Treasury at the time, it was put in with a 0.15% investment yield. And we worked with Starter Birch, and we did well enough that we're at 0.79%.
Wow. Really?
Yep. So big.
They want some of my cash?
Yeah, a little over $1 million, I believe, is what they said, and dollar amount there. What does that mean? Does that mean we get more money to put into the schools? No, but what it means is at some point there will be a board sitting here many years from now that can determine if they would like to shorten the time to pay off or the lower the millage rate at some point, because you can see that it would be paid off with that dollar amount going forward. So that's a good thing that occurred for the district, and Starter Birch has a great reputation in doing that, and they did a nice job helping us invest it as well, and worked with Carol and Bob over a number of days to prepare for it. It all happens on one day, because when you take the bid, it's like within 2 minutes, those bid numbers would change if you don't accept the bid. So it's a pretty interesting process. I had been through it prior in my past years, and Bob Carroll got to sit in and work in there. If you want to add to it, Bob, feel free.
Yeah, it was just it's a very interesting process. It does happen pretty quick once it happens. I would tell you that the investments are all very secured. I think the other thing that kind of amazed me is they work very closely with, we'll call it a draw schedule. How are we spending the money? When do we need the money? And then they help us invest that so that, you know, we have the money when we need to draw it, but we also have invested to get the most out of it that we can while it's not being needed. And it's exactly like Mike said, that's the take on. So I think we were, you know, we had originally the 0.15 was just a little over 100,000, I think, when we put the first application in.
And as Bob said, it is secure, because we're not just investing our own funds. And so they're backed, all the investments are backed by the U.S. government for the safety and the returns, and that's how they know already the amount that you'll get in the return. So,
okay.
So, all right. Ask for approval for the investment of those proceeds.
I'll accept the motion.
I move we approve the 2015 bond proceeds investment. Is that it? Investment?
Yes.
All right.
Second.
Okay. Motion by Banja. Second by Scott. Any questions or comments?
Yay.
Yeah, yay. Exactly. And just so taxpayers understand, it's very secure and very drawable as we go along. That was the key.
Yes.
Okay, all in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? The ayes have it. Do I hand this to Gary?
Yes, specialized computers.
Yes. Bring you three recommendations for approval in the area of technology. This is the first impact of the passage of the bond and the draws of the bond for technology specifically. Two areas. One are the first two proposals, which really are things that we do on a regular basis. We turn over laptops for teachers after they reach the end of their cycle, and we replace them with new computers, etc. That we have been doing, but it's been coming out of general fund. Okay, this is part of the bond proposal that we can relieve that pressure from the general fund by using the bond dollars as part of the entire plan that's been created with our draw schedule and part of Malo. The other are for some computer labs that are specialized. CAD, Tech Ed, and graphic arts that require certain type of computer with certain speeds and memory, etc. And those are in need of replacement, and we are going to be putting in all the one computers there. And so those are two things that we would have had to try to work into an already squeezed budget-free bond. So that's 3.6 and 3.7. And then 3.8 is expansion of technology, as we had talked about, the better access for students. And we are going to start that at the middle school level with computers, laptop computers, for elementary students to use at school so they have regular access. Why would we choose middle school? Well, a couple of reasons. Number one, out of all the three levels, that's the most heavily demanding area for online testing, because we have all three grade levels doing that, okay? So that'll meet an immediate need. But secondly, secondly, we'll start working that cycle, and when the eighth graders move to the high school, we're going to be starting this at the high schools as well, so they'll get the rest of their career access on a one-to-one basis within the school day to these computers. And then we will be picking up the elementary as well. Down the road.
And that's 3.6. Any, accept a motion on 3.6, first of all.
I move we approve item 3.6, specialized computers for the specialized labs.
Moved by Angela and
second
by Patrick, thank you. Any questions on that to Gary?
We also
We also have Dave Dezick here, our interim IT director, who can answer any technical questions for those of you who dare.
I got to do a lot of those at FFO, so. Anybody else? Seeing none, we'll move into vote. All approving 3.6, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? The ayes have it.
Oh, so
3.7 is the same.
Same, yep.
Okay, we've already been through.
But that is the staff computers as well.
So okay. I move we approve item 3.7, which is the staff replacement laptops.
We'll do them all one at a time here.
Okay, support,
yeah. Support by Yvonne. All in favor of 3.7, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. All opposed? And then lastly, I'll take a motion on 3.8.
I move we approve item 3.8, the enhanced access computers for middle school students. Support that also.
Angela and Yvonne moved and supported. Any question or discussion? It's the same thing, but I'll, for good order's sake.
Well, this—I mean, this is very exciting.
Yes.
This is an enhancement, and
I was
knowing that we're going to all this online testing. This is very exciting.
You know, we hear everything from this direction, and we even hear from staff. But I actually was doing merit badge counseling for a Eagle Scout, and he came in and he had his citizenship of the community and had to interview a public official, so he. Why he selected me, I have no idea, but he did. And the first thing he asked me, with all this online testing, when are we getting our machines so that we don't have this lab all tied up and we can't do anything else for a week or two? I mean, it was right off the shoot. It was a very, I think it was because it was the week after everything. It was fresh on his mind. So our kids are feeling it too. So this is a good deal.
I really appreciate the look into the best practices and including the staff and choosing the best machine for our needs, and I was really impressed when we saw those machines in FFO and got to handle them and hear more of the details as to why and what goes into each machine and what goes into those decisions before purchasing. So I appreciate all the work that went into that.
Any others? All in favor of 3.8, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? The ayes have it. Thank you very much for all the homework. Now, any requests to address the board? Seeing no one out there.
Nothing to say.
We'll move on to FFO and turn it over to study committee minutes from Pam.
Okay, I'll read the study committee meeting minutes from June 8th. Dave Dezick, Interim Director of Technology, shared the details of the bond technology purchases that will take place this summer. The main focus will be on student enhancement access laptops at the middle school level. The committee was able to examine the HP ProBook 11 Education Edition laptop that would be purchased for middle schoolers. The price per unit is below projections of the preliminary bond budget. In addition to the middle school purchases, the specialized computer labs uses the CAD, Tech Ed, and Graphic Arts will be updated. And as a part of the annual staff replacement cycle, approximately 44 laptops will be purchased. Dale Jerome from French Associates discussed the series of 13 meetings that took place to assist in the design of the new elementary school to be built at the central campus. These programming sessions allowed the architect to receive input from the various stakeholders in the many basic design elements found in the elementary school. The process used ideas regarding a possible STEM school design, the stakeholders involved, and the input that was received at each of the 13 meetings was reviewed with the committee. The next step in this process is to examine the programming ideas versus the budget and development of a more detailed building plan. At this point, more input will be sought from stakeholders. Summer tax resolution. Mr. Cooper reviewed the summer tax resolution that would be presented to the board at this meeting. And then Midland Public Schools 2015-16 budget. Mr. Cooper reviewed the 15-16 MPS budget and the underlying budget assumptions, both on the revenue and expenditure side. The budget will initially be presented at this meeting tonight, as we saw, and the adoption will happen at the June 22nd Board of Education meeting. 2015-16 budget shows revenue of $78,409,105 and expenditures of $80 million. This is a reduction of $1.6 million in revenue and a reduction of $2.2 in expenditures. With a projected variance of $800,446, 1%, the anticipated shortfall is $835,097. This is a significant decrease from the $2,181,737 projected shortfall in the 2014-15 year. Next FFO meeting will be July 15th.
Questions or comments?
I did have a question that I wanted to ask, and I just didn't think about it until now. For these 1,900 laptops, did we purchase anything to protect those laptops, like by way of a case or anything? And I asked that because we discussed it a lot with the iPads. We had the military-grade cases for them, but this seems like a big investment, and I didn't see anything in the agenda.
No, we haven't yet because they're not intended to go home at this point.
So, okay.
The kids, we've had laptops in the district. We had about 2,000 laptops in the district, and we've had really good success with students not breaking them. We have, you know, a couple a year usually where we'll have a broken screen, but overall the breakage is not that high. So the kids know how to handle them, and they do a good job with them. The teachers do a good job of watching them. So right now, it wasn't a concern at the time when and if they go home with the students, then at that point we'd want to consider that.
Okay, great.
I'd also point out that we bought the heavy-duty version of the
right. Product.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
They have a reinforced hinge, metal hinge instead that goes 135 degrees.
Oh, great. I think that's, you know, important for the public to know. It's a million-dollar investment. We want to make sure that they're the right heavy-duty equipment. So, great. Thanks.
Thank you. We'll move on to the rest of finance and hand to Bob.
Okay, HIPPO 5.2 and 5.3 are for information only. We have gifts again, which is very good. Under 5.2, we have $4,000 for the Midland High softball field PA system, and that's from the Michigan Baseball Foundation. We also have $700 for Dow High from Phil Ligip, the Midland Community Foundation, and $200 for transportation for young entrepreneurs for the Midland Area Chamber. And then in 5.3, again for information, we have a local artist, Mr. Arnold Pope, who has donated a number of pieces of artwork, which were around here for a while, and I see now that they're going to be displayed at the Admin Center, H.H. Dow High School, and Midland High School. And then finally, the part that we need action on is 5.4. That's a gift totaling $17,195. That's for laptop computers and a computer cart. Woodcrest Elementary PTO. I think you've seen a couple like that from the elementaries. Kind of goes along with what Mr. Berlindy was saying about how the bond's going to work and the order's going to be placed. And so I think you see some elementaries, and again, just looking ahead, saying it's going to be a while, and PTOs that are stepping up and purchasing those. That needs board approval.
I'll accept the motion on 5.4.
For the $17,195 gift from the Woodcrest Elementary PTO for laptop computers and computer cart.
I'll support that.
Moved by Vaughn, support by Pam. Any question or comments?
Great work. The artwork donated by Arnold Cobb, Jerry being a science guy would appreciate. Talking about mixing STEM and art, he was a scientist, and it's his art that he saw through a microscope. Through his career, and he captured that in art, and it's hard to visualize until you go see it, but it's quite amazing. So, good mix of the two.
And thank you to everyone for all the wonderful gifts.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely, parents and community just keep stepping up. Mm-hmm. It's amazing. Bright future. Take a vote on 5.4. Then all in favor, say aye.
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 Opposed? The ayes have it. Move to HR and Gary. It is the essentially the last item on the agenda, and that is probably most appropriate this evening.
Thank you. The board and staff extend their sympathies to the family of Ms. Hazel Mayer, who passed away June 10th. She was a paraprofessional in the transportation department for 20 years, retiring in 1997.
Our sympathy to the family. Moving on, you see the list of correspondence, FOIA requests, and you'll see our scheduled activities of meetings going forward. Notice our July meeting is not an organizational meeting for us old timers who've been around, that was the organizational meeting. That happens after the elections now, so that will not happen until January. Now we'll move into study discussion session, and I'll start my right with Patrick.
All right. I just, like everybody else said tonight, all the support from the community, from everybody getting the budget balanced. We talk about the gifts we receive every week. Millage proposals, bond proposals being approved by the public. From parapros, making basically minimum wage to up to Mike, taking a pay cut. Everybody's giving something back. Everyone's done their duty to do this. And if I use my soapbox for a second, I think it needs to be said, you only can do that for so long before you start having program cuts and cuts to the classroom. We've done our part. We've made the cuts. We're lean. We're more efficient. At some point, members of the community need to like what they see. Call your official. Let them know we need more support. We need more help. We've done our job. We're doing our job. Hate to see what happens if we don't get that support at some point from state and above.
Thank you. Good comment. Yvonne.
I think there's a whole lot I can add to that. I agree with you 100%, Patrick. I just want to say again, thanks to Mike. I think you've really done a lot of amazing things since you got here, and I appreciate all of them. And, of course, all the gifts are wonderful. I had some other things I was going to say, and then I think I wrote them down, but I don't know where to put them. So, yes, I'm done.
Okay. Angela.
First, I want to congratulate Gary again and wish you well in your retirement. 41 years, right?
Correct.
That's amazing, and thank you for everything you've done for the district in so many different capacities.
It's been my pleasure. Thank you.
Yeah, we're going to miss not seeing you in there.
Secondly, I think it's exciting when we went through the agenda tonight just to start seeing some of the things that we're doing with some of our bond proceeds. You know, we have everything that from things people won't notice, like asbestos abatement, to, you know, some new exciting things with some of these computer purchases. So it's exciting to start being able to see some of this stuff that everyone worked really hard to get this bond passed, and now we're starting to use some of that money to do some enhancements. So that would be it for me.
It really is exciting. It's really going to be exciting once the big projects start and the public gets to see what's really developing and how things are going to come to fruition.
Yes, those Carlin children are just going to have.
I'm going to have. Four of them are going to come through.
Yeah, well, that's
great.
The Branstad children are a little bit, you know.
You guys miss out. We get the whole benefit. Mike, great job again, and we're happy, as everyone said, to have you here. Gary, congratulations. I missed the two meetings ago, so I wanted to tell you, fantastic career. 41 years is a long time to devote a big portion of your life to this district. I mean, you've given your heart and soul, and I appreciate that, and I'm sure everybody else does here as well. So, again, congratulations. And that's all I had tonight.
Very good. Last Friday, I learned of a friend who passed away, a big asset to our district, Ann Horoff at Plymouth Elementary. Mm-hmm. She didn't retire, so we don't see her in the study committee minutes, but she gave a lot to Plymouth Elementary, and I know the staff all band together and walked to her house last week in support of her and her illness. So, and then in the paper, when I read the obituary, it said that any gifts could be given to Plymouth Elementary, and I thought, wow, for a parapro, you know, talking about giving your heart and soul, it's just really, really touching. So our thoughts and prayers are with the Hora family as well.
Thank you. My turn. Gary, thank you. You know, in the last part of your career, you were the spear catcher for all of us and, you know, all the tough things that had to be done. And that can't be pleasant at times. But you did it because you knew the district would be better, our kids would be better because of what you did. That said, I got to sit next to Gary at the Midland High graduation. You know, and people that are not used to seeing Gary as a principal or a teacher and only seen him his last years as an administrator, it was great. Gary leaned to me and said, I remember when that kid did this, and I remember when that kid did that. Boy, I wasn't so sure about that kid, and I'm so glad to see what he's become. And I just said, that's a professional. That's a professional. So, Gary, let me lead a round of applause. And come around once in a while. We'll roast you. We'll roast you. We will roast you appropriately. And with that, I'll hand it over to Mike.
And I don't have a lot, but for the parents out there, 2015-16 calendar is posted on our website. I know they've been anxiously waiting for that. And today, Jerry and I walked the section of Dow High property in the back that Northwood has kind of talked to us about and met with them a little bit, so we have more information to share with you. We actually went out and walked the property, which helped me a little bit visualize and see what that what they're proposing to us, and we'll work through FFO as we move forward with that. And on Gary, I have had the fortunate, and I say fortune, when I was named superintendent at Algonac, I was a high school principal stepping into that role, nervous role, and my middle school principal when I was a student was now a 40-year assistant superintendent, and I asked him, would you at least stay two more years? He was like Gary, near retirement, to get me off to a good start. And when I came to Midland, I inherited a 40-year veteran assistant superintendent who gave me two wonderful years to get me off and started. So hopefully I can continue those years. And thank you, Gary, and you did a great job with that and kept me out of landmines a couple times where I probably shouldn't have been, right? That's it for me.
Anything else for the good of the order? Seeing none, we stand adjourned.